I had the one, basically the whole song came to me sitting in a car outside a school in Adelaide. It was a girls' school, actually. I don't know, there's no reason why it happened to be there, but it was a hot day. I was parked in the shade, and I Ain't the One came to me. The guitar style, the whole, most of the lyric, Rick came up with some wonderful lines for the second verse, which one being, well-dressed waxwork wound up to walk, which is just a great line.
It's a classic.
Yeah. But I was in this car going, you know, smoker's choking in the smoking room, fishes in the fish, and all that opening stuff. But I had the music, and this was at a time when we hadn't really kind of worked out our musical identity, if you like. So it was one of the earliest songs with the trademark Nik-Niks. In fact, I think it was the first song. And I came to the studio with this, and we recorded a demo, and we all got mark opens included. We actually were so excited, we started jumping up and down on the chairs and going, this is it, this is our sound. So the song is particularly relevant to our history in that sense. We started playing it on stage, and people who were maybe not that interested, like at Checkers, where, you know, the girls would be all on the dance floor, and as soon as we hit the stage, they'd disappear. They started to go, hang on, this is really good, and that, and so people started to come in.
Then the girls disappeared and the guys came up.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was kind of a breakthrough song for us in a way, and you know, I mean,
oh, we were standing on the chairs punching the ceiling.
Really?
Yes, this is it. We finally felt we had a unique sound. Various people would say to us, oh, you know, you should hear this and that, and on the radio, you know, that's what's being played, you should sound more like that. No, we want people to copy us.
And of course, there's also, you know, we're around AC/DC a lot, so we didn't want to sound like we were trying to be them. So, you know, that style that came through in I Ain't the One, and then very soon afterwards with Rick's song Take a Long Line, and Straight Jacket too, all those songs really fit into that whole Nik-Nik thing, which just gave us that, you know, no one reinvents music, but you come up with your own angle. And that was kind of our angle. I heard the Never Mind the Bollocks and went out and bought Never Mind the Bollocks Sex Pistols album, and that had a profound effect on me, a huge effect. It was one of those albums that was hard to listen to from start to finish. It was relentless, but the content was actually brilliant. So, you know, you mix influences like that with AC/DC and stuff that you grew up with, and then eventually, if you get lucky, you come up with something that's your own individual. It's really just an angle, isn't it? You know.
And then you get an audience that's you know, the walls are bulging with the numbers that we're getting in the rooms, and they want to move. They want to dance. The only thing they can do, literally, is jump up and down. So pogoing began.
Apartment.